LEGO Island is a game near and dear to my heart, and countless others too. The game is officially 25 years old now, and I think it's about time to relive the memories this game holds by installing it. Today, I'd like to show the installation process for LEGO Island in the year 2022. For this, I'll be using my Asus laptop and an LG USB DVD read-and-write drive. Also, apologies for the crappy quality. I was recording this with my phone, which has autofocus on, which is a huge pain, so bear with me a bit. Okay, first, let's boot up the laptop. Oh, I forgot the last time I shut this laptop off was for an update. Let's jump straight to when Windows is up and running. With the power of movie magic, let's get the show on the road. And to get the process started, we need a physical copy of LEGO Island. Next, we have to put the CD in my computer. in my DVD drive. Since this is a drive like what you'd find on certain laptops, the tray has to be pushed in. Here we go. And there's the auto run. Here's the thing, this copy I have of LEGO Island is version 1.0, which means that the auto run didn't start up automatically when I put in the DVD. But now that it's up on my screen, we have a few options. We have install, readme, and cancel. Obviously, since I want to install LEGO Island, let's click install. This takes us to an old-fashioned setup installer. Here we can select our directory, but for the sake of authenticity, I'm going to keep the directory as the default. Clicking a few next buttons and away we go! It's copying a few files from the disk to store on the hard drive. After the installation is complete, it asks the user to install DirectX 5. Now, since this laptop is running on Windows 10 and DirectX 5 is wildly outdated, I'm going to avoid installing DirectX 5. We're booted back into the Auto Run menu, which has a few more options like configure, free stuff, and uninstall. Now that LEGO Island is installed, let's run the game! There it is. We have successfully installed LEGO Island. Now for full disclosure, I did have to kinda cheat by using the LEGO Island Alternative Installer and DigiVoodoo to get the game running. It seems that if I tried to run the game without any of the disk's files on the hard drive, with the disk still being inside my DVD drive, the game refuses to boot. While I would love to have the game run off the CD like how you would back in the day, I'm fine with doing this if it means making the game work. Hey, at least I got the game installed from the disk, so it pretty much counts for me. Anyways, happy birthday, LEGO Island.